Hi, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your Friday afternoon, your first Friday of 2022, Friday, January 7th, 2022. Today we're going to be talking about genuine hope from Bill Crowder, derived from 1 Peter 1, 3 through 9. So if you're excited about it being the first Friday of 2022, smash that like button. Let's see what a good question. What is your definition of genuine hope? That's a good one. Subscribe if you do, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me at least reach that 25 subscriber mark in 8 days for episode 600. But without further ado, genuine hope. Got a deck of hair on my chin that's stuck a different way, and I can't get it to quit sticking straight out. Hope I can get this done before it gets a little too dark. So I've got this video, and then I've got tonight's turning point to do left to do in this session. So maybe I can get it done before it gets too dark. Cause you know it gets dark after 5:30. So between 5:30 and 6, it starts getting dark. So just hopefully I can get it done in the daylight. Without having to use the light for a change, too. But genuine hope, Bill Crowder writes, in the early 1960s, the U.S. was filled with anticipation of a bright future. Youthful President John F. Kennedy had introduced the new frontier, the Peace Corps, and the task of reaching the moon. Thriving economy caused many people to expect the future to simply let the good times roll. Then the war in Vietnam escalated. National unrest unfolded. Kennedy was assassinated. And the accepted norms of that previous optimistic society were dismantled. Optimism simply wasn't enough. And in its wake, disillusionment prevailed. Disillusionment prevailed. Then in 1967, theologian Jurgen Moltmann's A Theory of Hope pointed to a clearer vision. This path wasn't the way of optimism, but a way of hope. The two aren't the same thing. Moltmann affirmed the optimism is based on the circumstances of the moment, but hope is rooted in God's faithfulness regardless of our situation. So what's the source of this hope? Peter wrote, "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." 1 Peter 1:30. Our faithful God has conquered death through his son Jesus. So the reality of this greatest of all victories lifts us beyond mere optimism to a strong, robust hope. Every day and in every circumstance. So whether you're an optimist or a pessimist, what situation calls concern in you? And why is hope better than either optimism or pessimism? That's a good one to answer there. Why is hope better than optimism or pessimism? But we have hope through God. That's my understanding. So ponder that by saying, God, this world is distressing and confusing, and many voices want to drive me to a perspective that feels void of hope. Help me to root my heart in the promise and power of the resurrection of Jesus, who holds the future. And read, and for more understanding about hope, read Hope, Choosing Faith Instead of Fear, at this website, discoveryseries.org/Q0733. I'll be sure to put a link in the description. I'll put the web page in the description box. So if it comes up as a link, then you can just click on it. But if not, just highlight it, right click it, and go to it. Because it'll pop. On mine, I highlight it and it says go to whatever that website is. Or the way I put it, and it goes right to it. Sometimes it'll go up to a search page and you click on it. Your Bible reading for this one today is Genesis 18 and 19 and Matthew chapter 6, verse 1 through 18. So, coming up tomorrow, we're going to be Drawn Near from Christian Holmberg, derived from Leviticus 16, 1 through 5. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that sometime later today. Later today on Friday. And I'll get to the Saturday and Sunday Devos in that sometime later today. Hopefully in the same time. I could do it with the... But coming up in your turning point for tonight, for Friday, January 7th, in episode 131. Yeah. We're going to be going through obedience training. Your beginning passage is Romans 6:17, which we'll read in Romans 6:15-19 in the recommended reading. We have a footnote in the first section from Brendan LaChance. I'll read the whole footnote in the video. And your turning point is from Greg Groeschel, Groeschel. And your Bible reading for that one is Genesis 24 and 25. Whoa, way up. It is what it is, but I love you, I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022. And peace out until later. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Friday afternoon. Come back again tonight for obedience training. And we'll see what that's all about. But until then, goodbye.